Yo, what is going on, guys? It's your boy SesO here, and before the video starts, I want to say thank you guys so much. We are at 9.6k. We are so close to 10k. I mean, we've blown up. You and I have done this together. Whoever's watching this video and just like, you know, whoever subscribed to me, like my video, shared my video, comment on my video, just did any kind of support that just helped me and grow. We all grew together, and it's a really good feeling having almost 10,000 people enjoy your content or enjoy what you do and enjoy listening to your voice, watching your tutorials, or just learning graphics from you. And it's just something I want to pursue for the rest of my life as a career choice. So it's a really good feeling. So I really want to say thank you guys so, so, so much. And I'm also going to be hitting 10K subscribers with two friends of mine by the name of Drone Concepts and Quezzy. They're both at maybe 9.7K for one and 9.8K for another. They're really close as well, so please go subscribe to them as well in the description below if you haven't checked them out. They're really good artists as well, and they also do tutorials. So if you guys want to check them out, you guys can. So anyways, 200 likes in this video. 200 likes in this video equals the secret giveaway. So don't forget, if you get 200 likes in this video, come back. If it's already at 200 likes, you want to download the secret giveaway. It's something new, something different, something just random out of nowhere that has to do with graphics content. If you haven't downloaded any of my other secret giveaways in my previous videos, make sure you guys do that. It'll help you out. You'll probably just be like, I don't know. It's really gone blah, 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 blah. What am I saying anymore? But I'm really thankful for, I just want to basically give you guys another, you know, just want to help you guys out even more and for helping me out, giving me whatever, you know, likes or whatever. I know I'm saying thank you a lot. I just really want to say thank you because I'm really hyped for 10K. So yeah, let's get to the tutorial now. I'm doing a web tutorial in Cinema4D. It's a really simple tutorial. You've probably already seen this before, or probably this will affect somewhere else, but it's a really good tutorial I want to have on my channel. It's like how to make webs. You can also take, like, you know, previous tutorials that I've done and, like, kind of combine this, like, tutorial with other ones, so we kind of, like, make this, new little add-on effect or some abstract design. You can also take, you know, displacement materials, put this on the web, make it more raspy and kind of, like, you know, just, like, falling apart. It's a really good effect. If you guys want to take some time to do that, that can work. I mean, you guys will, that's an insane effect. So if you ever want a new style or something to work with, do that and, like, kind of, like, work with that. It's a really good thing to do. So anyways, you can see the final image in the description below. I'm going to click on this right here just to show you guys what this is. This is the render of it. So you kind of see like the little, the web, you know, quote unquote web in between like the W, the E, and the T. You can kind of see how this goes on. And it's just basically the concept of having like this like spider in between like, you know, crevices or, you know, opening spaces and kind of like making this little web and corners or something. So it's kind of like really cool. Let's exit out of this. It's really simple and fast to do. So you just want to go to MoText, MoGraph. And let's get started with your text right here. So we're going to just put this to the middle. So just place this in the middle. Put this on bold. And we're going to change the text name back to wet. And we're going to put the depth to about 65. And we're going to go to the caps. Go to fillet cap for both of them. Go to our steps and radius and change to both the two. As long as with this one. And then once you're done with that, you're all done with your mo text. And what we're going to do now is click on your mo text. Go to mo graph. Effector random. If you don't know what random does, it just basically randomizes whatever selection or object you put inside of it. If you do it with Nitro Blast or, you know, Thrassy, it's a really good little thing you can do as well. But for me, what I like to do is put my effector strength to about 35. Go to my parameter, go to rotation, and if you don't know what rotation does, it just kind of like rotates it and also randomizes as well with all the letters or objects you put inside of it. So it's a little. I have a little preset. So if I put a negative 60 for the H, negative 75 for the B, and then if you or for the P, and if you go to B and put it on about 40 or 30 or so, it kind of gives it like a more like a cool rotation, kind of like randomizes it like really cool. I don't know, it just looks really nice. This effect also works, if I haven't said in the beginning, it also works with like any object or any like, you know, logo or something or AI if you want to do that. So before I go on, so yeah, you want to do is just duplicate the Motex, just press Control C, Control V for the shortcut, and then you just want to go ahead and go to your NURBS tab and go to Hyper NURBS, click on Hyper NURBS. Drag your duplicated text inside your hyper NURBS. Once you're done with that, if you don't know what hyper NURBS does, it basically kind of like just curves your whatever object you put inside of it. Kind of like makes it more curvy and more like not so, you know, sharp edged. Kind of just makes it like more rounded. So once you're done with that, you want to go to your atom array. So it's in your array tab. Go to your atom array. Click on your hyper NURBS. Drag it right inside your atom array. And then once you're done with that, you want to click on your atom array. Go to sphere radius. Just change it to 0.3. The lower you go is just basically how thinner the webs will get. 0.3 is kind of like the default for it, I guess you could say, how like thick your web should be. If your cylinder didn't change to 0.3, make sure you change that to 0.3 as well. And then once you're done with that, you want to click on your atom array. Take your blue arrow right here on your movement tool. just drag it right behind the text, just like so, just a little bit, and it'll, so it's just not on the frontal or the front face of the first text that we did, or logo, whatever you're using it with. And then you're basically done. You want to take maybe like a really nice, you know, soft, light material, put it on cubic, seamless on top of the atom array for your webs. That's basically your web thing. So like I said, if you want to put like a displaced material, this is where you will place it at, you know, the atom array. And then you just place this material right here. And then you're all good. So yeah, thank you guys so much, so much, so much for watching. Thank you guys so much for all the support. Don't forget, 200 likes in this video equals the secret giveaway in the description below. Make sure you guys follow me on Twitter at SesOHQ if you want to request any like tutorials or anything, or you want to keep me updated, or just, you know, see me freaking spam your Twitter line. And so yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget, freaking help my friends out, Quezzy and Drone. It'd be awesome if you guys did that. Kind of like a little, you know, surprise, get like, you know, shout out for them. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll talk to you guys later. So switch you out.